In this part, we'll be talking about different types of woods. So what exactly is wood? We have discussed in the previous part that wood is nothing but secondary xylem. And secondary xylem is formed due to the activity of cambium ring. Now we are talking about different types. The first classification is based on the season. On the basis of seasons. In the previous video, we talked about there are seasons which during which the activity of cambium is affected. Spring season is a favorable season, so cambium activity is more. So, if the secondary xylem is produced during spring, then we would call it spring wood. Spring wood would have bigger vessels. And this is due to more active cambium. The wood which is formed in winter is known as autumn wood. And autumn wood has smaller vessels. And these two layers actually made up the annual ring. So this classification is based on xylem, secondary xylem produced in which season. So this differentiation is basically on the basis of the size, bigger vessels or smaller vessels. The second classification is, where is the wood found? Is it in the central part or in the peripheral part? On the basis of location. The wood which is in the center of the tree trunk is known as heartwood. Anything which is in the center is normally termed as heart. And the peripheral one, which is on the outer side, is known as sapwood. If we cut a tree and we look at the section, we find that the central part is darker. And this is actually the hardwood. The peripheral wood is slightly lighter. Now, what makes this wood darker? It is dark due to deposition of organic substances like tannins, essential oils, resins. These are the substances which are deposited. And because of these substances getting deposited here, the hardwood is darker in color and it is most durable. And that is why hardwood is also known as duramen. It is very, very durable. Just to give you an example, the best wood is obtained from Tectona grandis. Tectona grandis is commonly known as teak wood. This is the best quality wood that we talk of. Now, if we purchase teak wood furniture, then the furniture or any object made from this central part, that is hardwood, is going to last for hundreds of years. This is also durable. This is also very good quality wood. But here, it is lighter in color because these substances, tannins, oils, resins, they are deposited in less amount. These substances, they make it very durable because of these oils, aromatic substances, the infection or termite kind of organisms would never attack. So if you purchase something which is made up of this central part, it is going to be expensive, but it is going to last for hundreds of years. And when we visit some monuments, we find that the wooden frames of the doors, they are made up of teak wood. And it lasts for thousands of years without any maintenance, without anything. This is because of this natural property of the wood. Sapwood is lighter. It is lighter in color. And this is due to less deposition of organic substances. Due to less deposition So this classification is based on where exactly the wood is. If it is in the central part, it is called hardwood. If it is in the peripheral part, it is known as sapwood. The third classification is on the basis of whether the wood is of angiosperm or it is of gymnosperm. That means which type of plant. Angiospermic wood is known as hardwood. Hardwood is angiospermic wood. That means the wood which is produced by all the flowering plants, it is called hardwood. And softwood. Softwood is gymnospermic wood. That means in gymnosperms, the wood which is produced is soft. As the name tells us, if we just go by the name, it is hard and this one is soft. But in reality, both the woods are hard woods. Then why are they calling one hard and the other soft? The reason is that what exactly is this wood made up of? Hardwood, because it is of angiosperms, it is made up of vessels. Vessels are lignified cells and the lignified walls are thick. Because of these thick walls, the lumen is narrow. In case of gymnosperms, the wood is made up of tracheids. Tracheids are also lignified, but the wall is thinner as compared to the vessel. So the lumen is wide, and when we see big holes, then it looks like a sponge. And when anything looks like a sponge, the general perception is that it has to be soft. But both the woods are equally hard. And gymnospermic wood is also used for construction work, making furniture, and almost everything. Difference or the name has been given on the basis of how it looks. And the reason is, one has vessels where the lumen is narrow and the other has tracheids where the lumens are wider. So this is which plant or which type of plant is producing this wood. One more important thing which is not associated with this chapter directly, but we have taken gymnospermic wood here because we wanted to discuss about angiosperms. This part is exclusively for gymnosperms. It is known as pycnoxylic wood, and the other one is known as mannoxylic wood. Both the woods are gymnospermic wood. So basically, it is the classification of gymnospermic wood. Pycnoxylic wood is with more xylem and less parenchyma. That means xylem, when we are talking about, we are talking of tracheids. So there are more tracheids and less parenchyma. Whereas in this case, there is less of tracheids and more parenchyma. And we will write down the examples also. Pycnoxylic wood is found in Pinus and mannoxylic wood is found in Cycas. So both are examples of gymnosperms. So this would be coming only when we are talking about gymnospermic woods. So this is how we classify woods, and either it is the season, location, or the type of the plant. The substance or the tissue which is there is secondary xylem. Now where it is produced, how it is produced, in which season, we have given it different names. So this is how we classify, and this part is exclusively for gymnospermic wood. So wood basically is secondary xylem, and these are the different ways in which we classify.